invite Senator Yusuf Haji.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, in Kenya we say all protocol observed because I cannot mention everybody here. Let me begin by expressing my gratitude for the invitation that the Universal Peace Federation has extended to me to be part of this end of year meeting. It is a great honor, and I do not take it for granted. First and foremost, when Dr. David and Patricia wrote me a letter inviting me to be here today, I could not at the moment hesitate to come, in spite of the fact that I had a bigger assignment in the country, which I had just concluded, and I was supposed to follow it very closely. Among the many dignitaries who have in one way or another been part of peace-building initiative across the world, this gathering serves as a testimony that together, and indeed by sharing our experience from the world, we can learn from each other and working hand in hand to create a long-lasting, reconciliatory and peaceful world. Let me now turn to my own experience, where I hasten to say that my journey as a mediator in quest for peace has largely been confined to my own country and the neighboring states. In this journey, I have found that my professional career as a provincial administrator in my country, Kenya, had a profound effect on my role as mediator. My position as an administrator prepared me for peace mediation, that task that I eventually engaged in, as I shall highlight shortly. Coming from a Kenyan pastoralist community where the youth, especially during my time, spent most of their early years taking care of animals as by the culture tradition, I did not get the opportunity to enroll in this very enticing labor practice and sport. Indeed, at a very early stage, I was recruited to take care of human beings as an administrator, which I have done throughout my life, and what I understand most, which is not a normal thing for a pastoralist. After many years as administrator, I joined politics, where I served as member of National Assembly for 15 years, and now doing my second term as the senator for Garissa County, totaling to 4 terms as member of parliament. I previously served as assistant minister in the office of the president, and also served as cabinet minister, first as Minister for Cabinet Affairs, and later as Minister for Defense. As you clearly see, my whole life has been spent serving and representing people. Hindsight, this might be one of the reasons that I was asked on several occasions to help in mediating between warring factions and a conflict situation. Let me now enumerate some of the said conflicts that I have been called upon to mediate. Ladies and gentlemen, in my years of service, I have mediated upon the following conflicts. One, conflict between Kenya and Ethiopia as chairman of the Administrators' Peace Committee between 1992 and 1996. Conflict between the Ethiopian Federal Government and Ogaden National Front, Mediation Committee between 2012 and 2018. Third, conflict between President Farmajo of Somalia and the regional president of Jubaland, also in Somalia, called Ahmed Madobe. Fourth, Moyale inter-clan war in 2014. Five, Mandera inter-clan conflict in Kenya in 2014, a war which displaced many household men from one community of the Somali community, leading to loss of lives and massive destruction of property, including livestock. I also mediated differences between the two counties of Mandera and Wajir and successfully concluded. In my own home, Garissa, there was a boundary conflict between Garissa and Wajir County, which I also mediated and settled it peacefully. While mediating such conflict, one has to balance the national interests of the respective states as well as the needs and livelihood of the communities concerned. The nature of these conflicts are mostly multifaceted, ranging from boundary-driven conflict, resource-based conflict, ethnic-based conflict, as well as clan-based conflicts. In order to understand any conflict, one must find the depth and root cause of the problem at hand. In most cases, my team has taken the approach of engaging clan elders, political and religious leaders, and together made a fact-finding mission to the conflict-affected areas. In most of the cases above, we have successfully brokered peace and life return to normalcy. When I talk of this conflict, it's a conflict whereby people lost life in great number and properties as well. As the current chairperson of the Standing Committee on National Security, Defense, and Foreign Relations in the Senate of Kenya, I continue to ensure oversight of a range of issues regarding peace and security. The committee is mandated to consider all matters relating to national security and foreign relations, disaster reduction and preparedness, home affairs, defense, immigration, and international relations. It is one of the busiest committees in Parliament because of the numerous security concerns raised inside Kenya as well as East Africa. So far, the committee has dealt with legislation, petitions and statements on cotton rustling, resource-based conflict, disarmament process by the government, in particular communities, treatment of prisoners, treatment of ex-servicemen and veterans, registration of persons, among others. Last but not least, my latest task in this search for peace journey has been my chairing the Building Bridges Initiative. That was as a result of the handshake between incumbent President Uhuru Kenyatta and the former Prime Minister and leader of the opposition. Some of you maybe have read it in the press that after our election, President Uhuru was declared as the winner. The former Prime Minister appealed against the result of the election. The matter went to court, and the first time in the history of Africa, there was a repeat election, whereby President Uhuru won the election. When President Uhuru went to be sworn as the president, the Honorable Raila declared himself as the president of the people, and he went to a place whereby he was sworn as a president. You can imagine, in one country with two presidents, what would have been the result? A disaster which have never been seen in the world before. So when they came together, President Uhuru and Raila, they discussed and they saw that the country is greater than their individual personalities. And therefore, they agreed to shake hands, which took many Kenyans as a surprise, because they were not seeing eye to eye. After this handshake, for the first time, the country became calm, and people were breathing sighs of relief. As a result of that, The president appointed Building Bridges Committee, and I was appointed as the chairman. And we were given 9 thematic areas on which to consult Kenyans on. One is the lack of national ethos, ethnic antagonism, competition, devolution, because for the first time we have a devolution now, 47 counties. Shared prosperity, divisive election, corruption, inclusivity, safety and security, and responsibilities and rights. We visited all the 47 counties and listened to a cross-section of Kenyans as well as individual stakeholders, in addition to political leaders. We are immensely gratified by how Kenyan people responded to our call for participation. The face of Kenya was captured with at least 7,000 citizens from all the ethnic groups, genders, cultural and religious practices, and different social economic sectors among forward eager to tell off their experience and solution to our pressing national challenges. We also heard from more than 400 elected leaders, present and past, prominent local voices from the community. We heard from 123 individuals representing major institutions, including constitutional bodies and major stakeholders in the civil and private sectors. In addition to that, we had 261 individuals and organizations who emailed in detailed memorandum and 750 handwritten submissions were made to the task force at the public forums in the county. Our analysis and reports showed that the problem is both in our hardware as well as software. Our hardware deals with legal, policy, administrative issues, while our software deals with everyday behavior and attitude. For both challenges, we have recommended homegrown solutions, even as we learn from best practices from the rest of the world, and we hope that our recommendation will help solve the conflicts that are witnessed in every election year in Kenya. The launch of the BBI report has been seen by all as a new dawn for Kenya. If you read the papers, even up to today in Kenya, they are talking about the recommendation of BBI. Finally, to all of you, I say thank you very much. I went to university in Birmingham, and I have just heard, as you people were deliberating about where the next conference will be, I will recommend Birmingham, because I know Birmingham. Even last year, I was in Birmingham, and I met a lot of people from the diaspora, a lot of them, and I had the opportunity to talk to them about the need for them to live peacefully in the UK and also participate in building the nation, since this is now their home and their country and the future of their children. With those few remarks, Father David, I have told you, and Madam Patricia, please welcome to Kenya. Welcome to Kenya. If you come to Kenya, I'll make arrangement for you to visit the president and also share your experience worldwide. So thank you very much, and may God bless you.